Hi DIYers, Joe here from Alarm Grid, and today we're going to talk about how to interface a 5877 relay module with your Lyric system. Now, what the relay module is going to let you do is open and close a garage door. You may be able to find some other functionality with it, but that's mainly the purpose of why it's made. We have one right here, and if you take a look, you'll see that there's an LED in the middle of the module. What this does is allows you to see the status of the system after you walk in the garage. So gives you a quick update just by looking at it. If it's flashing red, it means that the system's armed away. If it's solid red, it means that the system's armed stay. If it's solid green, it means the system's ready to arm. If there's no light, it means that the system is not ready to arm. And if it's flashing orange, it means that there's currently an alarm on the system. Now, if we look inside of the module, there's a few things on the board. We have the LED light that shows the status. There's the barrel connection for the plug that connects to a transformer that you plug into a regular 110 outlet. And then you have your terminals, which you can wire in or connect it to a garage door motor. So for example, let's say in your garage you have a button that opens your garage door. The button may be connected to the garage door motor via a wire. Most of these buttons work with normally closed loops, just like a security contact. And by connecting this in line, you can actually have it work in conjunction with the button. As you see here, I've connected a wire. So if we use our imagination, we can pretend that there's a button on this end of the wire, and then this end of the wire would go up to the garage door motor. So if that's the case, all you'd have to do to install the module is cut into the wire, and then connect it to the like terminals. So it's just gonna be common to common and the normally closed to normally closed. Most buttons work on normally closed, but this does have a normally open loop if you need to use that. Also, if your garage door or if your garage doesn't have a button to open the door and there's only the motor, on many motors there's terminals for normally closed or normally open loops where you can interface this right into the motor itself. So in either situation, you should be able to get this connected to the garage door motor. Some of the other things on the board, actually the only other thing, is the test button right here. So now, if we look at our system, this actually learns in a little differently than other devices on the Lyric security system. There's an entire garage door section on the system that you're going to have to program this in on. There's one thing to keep in mind with this device is that if you only program in the 5877 to the Lyric system, you'll only be able to operate the garage door from the Lyric system itself. If you want to be able to control it via Total Connect, you'll need to add a contact onto the garage door in a certain zone on the system. The Lyric security system can support 4 garage doors, and the contacts for each garage door have to go from zones 127 to 130. They are the ones that line up with the doors in sequential order. When you put a contact on the door, then the system is going to know the status of the door. You'll be able to use the door as a security zone, and you'll also be able to control the garage door through Total Connect, assuming that you have the automation feature. One of the most popular contacts for a garage door for monitoring it is the 5822T. This device here uses tilt to detect if the door is open and closed, and it can very easily mount right onto the garage door itself. So the garage door goes up and this tilts over. The system knows that it's open. When it closes, it knows that it closes. Programs in just like any other wireless device, and it's a great device to use with the 5877. Now, Honeywell also recommends using a Z-Wave siren with the 5877. I'll show you where the programming is. This is another special programmed device, as normally a Lyric, you wouldn't be able to interface Z-Wave sirens with it. If you program in a silent siren for the garage door, which is what Honeywell recommends, what it's going to do is it's going to enunciate when the door opens and closes, just to warn everybody that the door is operating. It's not critical to use that. You don't have to use it, but it is a recommended feature, and I'm going to point out where you program that in. So if we take a look at our system itself, on the main screen, if you click on automation, then you're going to click the down arrow, and then right here you'll see there's garage door setup. So if we click into that, you'll see we have the 4 garage doors that are possibly able to be programmed into the system. So if we click on garage door 1, you're going to see it says assigned device. Click on that, and then right on the top, assigned device. Oops, pardon me. Assigned device. Enter serial number. That's the next menu down. So on the 5877, there's 2 places that the serial number is located. There's a small sticker right here on the front beneath the plug. And then on the back, There's also a sticker right here on the bottom of the casing. Now, the serial number for this particular unit, you're going to have to manually enter it into the Lyric system. So if we take a look, ours is 0018730. We click done. And that's pretty much it. If we click the learn button now, this should cause the relay to trigger when I click it from the system. I don't know if you could have heard, if you heard that, but it did trigger it, and it just is telling me that it's programmed into the Lyric properly. That's a good thing to do before you mount it up on the ceiling in case you have to take it down to adjust any of the programming. So with that set, you'll also see on the bottom right here, it says include siren and exclude siren. If we click on include siren, you'll notice it loads up a Z-Wave enrollment mode. You'll need to use this particular function through this particular menu if you want to enroll a Z-Wave siren in for your garage door setup. And that's basically it. So if we go back, you'll see that it says garage door one assigned, and then on the prior menu, under automation, if we go to garages, you'll see that the garage door one is illuminated and we can trigger the relay by clicking this button. That's how you enroll a 5877 relay to a Honeywell Lyric security system. If you did enjoy the video, go ahead and hit on subscribe. And if you want to be updated about future videos when we post them, click the update button. If you have any questions or comments about the video, head over to alarmgrid.com, give us a call, send us an email, we'll be happy to help. Have a great day, and thanks for watching.